and dash. Okay. All the dipoles are oriented in several directions. Now we will see what happens if you apply a magnetic field. One person come here, many people come here. So we are stand the stage. Stage with the
magnetic field.
Now we are exposing the magnetic field. All aligned parallel to the field. Blur weight action. Fine. So when you are exposing to the magnetic field, all the protons align parallel to the field. Okay. But this alignment, essentially there are three protons. In actually, if you see, more number of protons will be in the less energy state. That is alpha state. And one or two protons will be in the high energy state. And the net orientation will be along the magnetic field axis. Okay, so the net magnetic field is along this axis. Now we will take a close-up of this part. So what happens here? We have a magnetic field. So in the presence of the magnetic field, all the protons are aligned. So you get something called as, what do you call it? What is the magnetic field that is established? What is the magnetic field that is established? You get longitudinal magnetization. Longitudinal magnetization is established. This magnetization is in parallel with the upright field. This magnetization is in parallel with the upright field. Okay? Now, another factor here is that we are going to have a close-up of the single proton. What happens? Okay, what the single proton does? What the single proton does? It oscillates about itself. That's called the spin. And you show the spin. Okay. So you have the effect of the individual proton. The spin that is slowly, 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 slowly. Okay, slowly. You have a spin. Okay. So the proton individually has a spin. So the spin, spinning charge produces a magnetic field. Okay. The spinning charge produces a magnetic field. You consider one proton, that is the net effect of the proton alone be considered. So the net effect is it spins actual and also it spins about the axis of your magnetic field. So what you have to do now? It is multiplication with so the proton spins around itself and actually what it does? Precesses along the magnetic field. It undergoes precession along the magnetic field. Okay? So this precession is called as a precession frequency. The frequency at which it presses. This frequency increases. If you increase the magnetic field strength, but we don't have a strong magnetic field. Okay, so you not increase the field strength. With this field strength, the proton is spinning on its own axis as soon as it spins about the set axis. Okay, fine. Now, to bring this proton, see this magnetic field is in actually in parallel to the upright magnetic field. This magnetic field is actually in parallel to the upright magnetic field. Now we want to pick out some useful information from this signal. We have developed this signal, but this signal is along the axis of your original magnetic field. To draw some information, you need to change the path from the original spin up state to spin down state. To bring about that condition, all of you, three of you are back. So now the three protons or the net effect of the protons is aligned parallel to the field. To bring about resonance, okay, I need a radio frequency pulse. Okay, I consider three radio frequency pulses. One is Rajita, Guruchandra Modi, and Shanti.
Thank you.
supply a white color, we are talking about resonance condition. Okay, resonance condition is the frequency you are supplying should match with the precision frequency. Only if it matches with the precision frequency, you get an energy transfer taking place. The resonance condition will be. Okay, of these three radio frequency pulses, only this radio frequency pulse can cause resonance condition. Okay, so give an answer to Bhagneya. So resonance is essentially sharing of energy. Resonance is essentially sharing of energy. The energy from your radio frequency pulse is transferred to your protons. Thereby, the protons get a new field, new energy, and slowly their protons start to align in the direction of the applied radio frequency pulse. Stand here. Now, the radio frequency pulse is there, energy has been transferred. So, now what you do? All of you align towards Ranjita. Now, what happened? Due to the application of the radio frequency pulse, the energy transfer took place, and from the spin up state, it was transferred to spin down state. Okay? So, the new magnetization vector is formed. This magnetization vector is called as transversal magnetization. This magnetization vector is called as transverse magnetization. Okay? So when this transverse magnetization is reduced, okay, can you move that? Go to the end. Okay. When this transverse magnetization is reduced, slowly what happens? This transversal magnetic field will reduce and long term magnetization will form. When you do it again, now you are in the direction of the applied magnetic field. நீங்கள் வந்து என்ன பண்ணணும்னா சொல்லலாம் வந்து அபிநயா கை கொடுக்கணும். அபிநயா கை கொடுத்தோன்னா கை கொடுத்து இங்கே வந்துருக்குங்க. ஸோ தே வில் ஆல் அலைன் இந்த டைரக்ஷன் டுவர்ட்ஸ் யூ. யூ வில் கெட் யுவர் ட்ரான்ஸ்பர்சல் மேக்னடைசேஷன். ஆஃப்டர்வர்ட்ஸ் யூ கோ பேக் அண்ட் தே வில் அலைன் பேக் டு தேர் ஒரிஜினல் போசிஷன். ஃபைன். ஸோ நவ் இட் இஸ் எ லாங்கிட்யூடல் மேக்னடைசேஷன். ஓகே, ட்ரான்ஸ்ஃபர் ஆஃப் எனர்ஜி டேக்ஸ் பிளேஸ், ரெசனன்ஸ் கண்டிஷன் அக்கர்ஸ், and the protons align in sync with the applied radio frequency pulse. Okay, and this does not last longer. As long as the radio frequency pulse is available, this sync will be available. And once the radio frequency pulse loses or it is stopped, they will come back to their original position, that is, in the field parallel to the applied field. Okay, now this are concerned or characterized by two factors, two time constants. The rate at which your transverse magnetization reduced and the rate at which your longitudinal magnetization was established. The rate at which your transverse magnetization reduced is given by a constant called spin-spin relaxation time. It is given by a constant spin-spin relaxation, and the rate at which longitudinal magnetization is established back is governed by a time factor called spin lattice relaxation. Okay, these two time factors in turn help you to identify your spectrum. Okay, they are living very high energy state. If they are in high energy state for a long amount of time, will have a very sharp absorption peak. Will have a very sharp absorption peak. If it is having less number of less time excited state, the absorption peak will be wide. Okay, so now when it comes back to the thing, it is not coming out simply. We are talking about, so in first Fourier transform, when they come back to the relaxed state, when they come back to the relaxed state, they give out some signal. Okay, they give out some signal. That signal is called as, what is that signal called? Free induced decay. That signal is called free induced decay. So I require a detector to catch the output. Can you call a detector? Jayalakshmi. Jayalakshmi is is a detector which is going to track the signal. What you have to do is that you will enact it again. So it will start again from here. Okay? So they are initially ground to transmutation. You have to give a shining energy. They are arranging in transverse magnetization. Once transverse magnetization is lost, so you have to make it slow. The slow, you give away the energy to her. Okay, she will give a handshake to you, and that signal will be recorded by her. Okay, do it. Be back. You will be in the motion. Start. So we have the longitudinal magnetization again. We have a resonance condition taking place. And the energy transfer takes place, and the protons align, and a new magnetization transfer magnetization is formed, and soon the RF pulse is removed. So make it slow, give your signal to her, and slow, slow down by putting the other number. Fine. So this signal is called as a thing. You have free induced decay, and you have the signal in your receiver. This signal is take, you take the Fourier transform of the signal and you find good. Thank you.